Hello everyone. In this video, I will be showing you how to add default constraint to an existing column in MySQL. So I will be showing you two ways or two commands how you can add a default constraint to an existing column. So let's get started. So currently I'm having here a sample table latest, and this table has just two columns. As you can see over here, it has roll number and name, subtype int and varchar, and it does not have any constraint. Okay. So now I'm going to add a default constraint to any one of these columns. So if I have just inserted 1 and a over here. So if you just go here, you can see. Now let me show you the first way how to add a default constraint to this name column. So it's going to be alter table and the table name, which is latest over here. PST. And we will go with modify our column name that we want to add the constraint. So it's going to be name, the data type of our name column, which is varchar 20. Varchar 20, and you need to use the default keyword default, and you need to specify the default value. Okay, so I will just put capital ABC to be my default value over here. That's it. And this alter table modify varchar default can be in caps or lowercase letters, but this thing, this name and data should be as how we have specified earlier. So this is the command, really simple. Alter table, table name, modify your column name, data type of the column, default keyword, and the default value. So now let me just run this one. So I'm getting a green mark over here. So if I just go over here and let me just insert, let me insert two, okay, and I will just put here roll number. So what this line does is that I'm just inserting for this roll number column, and I'm not inserting anything. So it doesn't mean null. I'm not inserting anything in this name column. Okay. So now what will happen is that 2 will be going for roll number, and our default value ABC will be going for name column. So if I just run it now, putting green mark. So if I just go over here, and as you can see here, I'm getting 2 ABC. So just inserted 2 ABC is coming by default. And another important thing is that since our name column is of type varchar, I am specifying this as a string that is within double quotes. So if it is like a normal integer or int, you can just put 1 without any quotes. Okay. So now I will also show you the second command or way how we can add this default constraint. So now I will just add to this roll number column. Okay. So I know that this R number is like a primary key, but just for demo purpose, I am going to add a default value to it. But it isn't the primary key. Okay. So this is the first command that we used earlier. So now I will also show you the second command. It's going to be same alter table, table name. And here we will use again the alter keyword, alter, where we want to add the default constraint. So which is roll number here, roll number, and we will use set default and the value that we want to have. So it will be say 100 should be my default value. Okay. So this is the command alter table latest, alter roll number, set default 100. So these are just the keywords. Okay. Keyword. These are the keywords, and rest are the values, column name and row table name that you are specifying. So let me just run this now. So I'm getting a green mark. So if I just go over here and let me insert for my name column, let me put B over here. So if I just run it. So I'm just inserting for this name. I am just leaving blank for roll number, but I will have 100 B in my table. So if I just go over here. So as you can see here, I'm having the default value 100B, and let's also do this. Okay. So I'm not going to insert any values. It's just a blank insert. Okay. So since we are having like default values for both the columns, I'm just doing this blank insert. So we will be getting the output as 100 and ABC. Okay. So let me just run this one. So if I just view this. So as you can see here, I'm getting 100 and ABC. I have inserted nothing. So just the default values are coming into play over here. So I hope you would have found this video useful. I have also run many other MySQL queries as well as interview questions, as well as programming videos in C, C++, Java, Python, as well as 3D animation in Blender. So do check other videos of my channel, subscribe and support me. Thanks for watching.